Hey everybody, just trying to get everything rolled out. What's going on, Michelle? Let me see. What's going on? What's the problem? Are we streaming? All but Twitch. What's going on with it? All right, screw it. Here we go. I hope everybody's doing good out there. Thanks for tuning in. This first song is called Almost Home. It's been way too long since I held you, darling. A thousand more miles, and I'll be by your side. I ache for you every night. It feels so wrong to settle down someday. For now I've got to stray. I'm still yours even when I'm not home. Tired, dirty, and bruised, but I won't sway. Only time and distance stand in my way. I drive through the light just to see a jade that shimmer in the morning light. I love you, darling, I'm almost home. All right. Are we all good now? Streaming on all? Sweet. Sorry for the technical difficulties at first, but that's life, and we're doing it live. My name is Sean James. Thank you for tuning in to episode 4 of Livestream at the Lodge. That song was called, it's an original called Almost Home. I wrote that one, I was on the road probably, 4 or 5 years ago. And I believe I was in the desert, New Mexico or Arizona. And I was kind of missing my lady, and everybody had gone to bed in the RV and trailer. And I got the guitar out the back of the trailer, and I climbed up on the RV, the roof, under the stars at night in the desert. It was gorgeous. And the song just was there, kind of just picked it out of the sky. It was what I was feeling, and it just came out and all worked out. One of the only love songs I've ever written. All right, let's see, what am I gonna do next? I'm gonna do something from The Dark and the Light. I haven't really performed this one much. It's kind of a heavy one. It's not Michelle's favorite. When I sent it to her, she wasn't so happy at first. This one is called When I'm Gone. Bury my heart in a willow tree. The branches give rise to the lowest leaves. Find shelter and shade in my arms. Once I'm gone, don't mourn for me. I hope you take pride in what I used to be. Let go. If you guys have any questions, send them on over, and I'll try to answer as many as I can. Again, this live stream is for charity. We are raising funds for COVID-19 relief through Doctors Without Borders, United Way, and Seattle's foundation. So if you guys feel the desire to donate, you can go to any of those websites. or you can just donate to my PayPal, seanjamessoul@gmail.com, or Venmo at seanjamesmusic, and I will forward all those funds as a donation myself. That last song is one I was called When I'm Gone. I wrote it a couple of years ago or so. Oh, there's the reverb. Nicely done, Michelle. Keeping them on their toes, you know? That one, I was looking at life and, you know, was wondering if I died, what would I be remembered for and what would be my legacy or, you know, what would I leave behind? And I was thinking about it and kind of contemplating over those things, and I started writing When I'm Gone. And yeah, it's kind of my thoughts on it all, you know. I don't really have much more to say about it, I guess. The song kind of contains everything. Let's see, what am I going to do next? Do you remember? I didn't write it down, did I? all right, I got it. This is an older one from an album I put out. The first album I put out called Shadows. Started as a starry night, turned into a horrid storm, and now my head is wet with the rain. It's not that I expected it, a plan for it to come. It sort of just ended up this way. I got a funny little feeling that I ain't gonna make it all tonight. But my mind's been spent praying all these midnight doors. I'm just calling to say that I love you and I'll be safe. And I'll see you when the morning time comes around. Yeah.
I got a funny little feeling that I ain't gonna make it home tonight.
Yeah, that one's really hard to understand. I wrote that. I believe it's kind of fuzzy, the memory of that one, but I think I was out a little bit too late one night having too much fun and probably crashed at a friend's place and called Michelle and told her I wasn't going to make it home. And there's the premise for the song. I was a little too drunk, I guess. Didn't feel safe. Who knows? Maybe just having too much fun. Question time. All right, let's do it. Gear rundown. Well, I'm not using much gear right now. I've got my Gibson Hummingbird. Beautiful Gibson. I love them for hooking me up with this. And it is stringed with Elixir strings. Both of them sponsor me, and I'm very, very appreciative to them. They make some of the best products, and I love it. But yeah, the keyboard is just a digital keyboard going through, you know, a software instrument plugin. It's not much of a rundown. And then the microphone is a Shure SM7B. I've used a bunch of different kinds, and I've got a few, but this one seems to be serving the purpose right now. All right. Any other songs inspired by mythology? Tons, you know. Practically the whole On the Shoulders of Giants record is inspired by a lot of myths and legends and tall tales and folk stories and stuff. And yeah, it's a lot of my songs have elements of mythology and legends in them because I just love a good story. So yes, there are many songs. Let's see. If you could change anything about the music industry, what would it be? Ooh, that's a loaded question. I would say if I could change anything about it, it would be, in one aspect, the artist's sense of being genuine and real. I see too many artists out there that are just kind of gimmicky and doing it for sales or doing it because they think it's going to get them lots of views or lots of streams, or I'm going to go viral, I'm going to be popular, I'm going to make so much digital money and blah, blah, blah. Or, you know, the one thing I would change is the facade of having to appear to be something that you're not, and kind of holding this, I don't know, false identity of self that I see in a lot of musicians. That's a complex answer, and there's much more. I could go on and on about the music industry and things I would change about it, but that's one of the ones that I see that kind of gets to me to my core, because once I think that someone is just phoning it in and just doing a gimmick or a shtick, I kind of lose respect for them, and I don't take them as serious. You know, you got to be genuine. You got to make me believe you. You know, do I believe that you're telling the truth? Do I believe that you say what you mean and you mean what you say through your music? A lot of times, no, sadly. But yeah, the main thing is be genuine, be real, and you know, everything else will kind of follow suit. All right, when did you learn guitar? Well, I got my first guitar, I want to say I was mowing lawns all summer. I saved up enough money when I was like 14 or 15, and I had this old hand-me-down, a classical guitar from my dad that he got in the 70s. It was a cheap one, and the neck was like huge, and my 13, 14-year-old fingers couldn't really play it right, and I got really discouraged with guitar, and so I put it down, and I didn't play it, and then eventually I got, I think it was like a Fender something or other, and I learned a few chords, but honestly I was never that interested. I was always interested in singing in high school and in my teenage years, and I really truly didn't pick up the guitar and actually learn the basics till I was in my early 20s, like 22, 23, something like that. So for those of you out there that don't play an instrument, there is still hope. And I'm not even that great, but it enables me to make the music that I want to and write the songs and tell the stories and to sing over the things that I want to. All right, all right, all right. Working on any new songs? Yes. I've got about 3 in the bank right now. They aren't finished, but I've got some really good ideas for. And the more time I spend home and not touring, the more ideas I get for songs. You know, it's weird. I don't really write on the road. I feel like my mind is kind of just focused on the day-to-day tasks and getting set up and getting ready and driving to the next location and doing the show and focused on performance, that it's just too much for me to think about writing in that time as well. So I tend to do a lot of my writing in solitude and when I'm home and alone. Also in these videos, I notice that I talk a lot with my hands and I do this, like this. It's, yeah, working on it. What's the other question? One more here. The inspiration behind Son of the Wolf. That was part of a concept EP I was working on about this man who was raised by wolves and eventually realizes that he's not like them and he doesn't fit in. And, you know, it's kind of a sad, somber EP, you know, of him realizing that he's going to be alone for the rest of his life and kind of wander around behaving like a wolf and having these traits of a wolf but not knowing why. And yeah, the inspiration behind Son of the Wolf is putting myself, creating this character and creating this world that the character lives in, and then putting myself in the shoes of the character and just feeling how I think that they would feel and seeing how, you know, just putting yourself in someone else's shoes. And there are tinges of real life stuff in there. My father was known as the Wolf Man. A lot of people ask, are you the son of the wolf? Yes, but no, not in the entirety of that song. There are some elements that I share commonalities with. But yeah, so there's a very roundabout answer to that question. Let's do another one, shall we? I'm gonna do another old one. Another old one. This is, you know, strangely, this one has never really been one of the most popular ones, but in the last 2 to 3 years, I get tons of requests for it, and it kind of shocked me at first, because I don't know, I never really thought of this song in that way. It's it's kind of a love song. I guess it examines love. Back when I wrote it, you know, I was seeing a lot of my friends and family and people I knew going through these toxic relationships where they weren't really appreciated and they were kind of used and taken advantage of when they thought that they were building something real and lasting, I guess, and the other person kind of fooled them and really pissed me off. And so I kind of approached this song from the stance of, you know, what might that person think when they wake up and then find out that it's not what they thought it was, and then comparing that to another person who'd saved their love for one person. And I'm not, you know, I don't judge. I think love is a very situational, circumstantial thing, and everybody has their own definitions of it. But this was just an examination of kind of like one person's soul love versus another person's reality, with coming to the terms that they maybe not, they don't have that. And so this one is called, If That's Love.
Thinking that she's one. such a thing in life until we meet again. She wonders if she's wrong or right, or to share her love with him. If that's love, then I don't know what is. If that's true, then I'm a fraud. If it's real, then I must seem like such a fool to have saved my love one. If that's love, then I don't know what is. If that's true, then I'm a fraud. If it's real, then I must seem like such a fool to have shared my love.
We'll do another round of questions if you guys want. So send... Oh, you already have it ready. Okie dokie. Again, thank you guys so much for tuning in. We are doing this for charity. I'm sure the links are up there, or they will be soon. We're raising funds for COVID-19 relief. For doctors, families, all sorts of people that are going through hard times. Again, you can donate at the websites for the charities, or you can send it to my PayPal or Venmo, and I will forward the donation after it's collected for like a week or so. Yeah, let's see. Standard guitar tuning. Yes, this is in standard guitar tuning. I also play... Actually, no, this is not in standard guitar tuning. I lied. Don't you look at me like that, Michelle. I can tell a lie and then reverse it. Put my thing down, flip it, and reverse it. You know? Man. this is actually tuned down a half step. It kind of gives a little bit of a darker feel and is more comfy on my vocals. Yeah. I don't always I do it in the moment. You know, I choose with how I'm feeling. That's because, you know, day to day, your vocals are going to be very different. There's some days I can't hit notes that I could the day before. And some days I'm demolishing high notes that I could never hit. You know, it's a fluid thing. You kind of just got to listen to your body and listen to your vocal cords and throat and adjust for what's necessary. I also play in open D, open D minor, standard, D standard. Yeah. Nothing too crazy, though. I Best thing about tour. Best thing about tour is this sense of freedom and adventure and spontaneity and just beauty of living in the moment that sometimes you take for granted in the day-to-day schedule that we get used to. When you hit the road, it's just like this, I don't know, for me, this sense of, like I said, adventure, you know, endless possibilities, but also a little bit of danger, but I like that, and it's just life. It's the best thing about tour is that adventure aspect and creating amazing memories and experiences with people who I don't know, but I get to meet at the shows who've been affected through the music, and it's a beautiful thing and is very inspiring to see how songs I create that help me maybe can help someone else and inspire them to do something or, you know, something like that. So that's really the biggest part of it, I'd say. What countries have you not visited yet? A ton. Where do I want to go? Pretty much everywhere I've never been. South America, Australia, New Zealand, Scandinavia. Russia, Scandinavia I've been, but I never played. Oh no, yeah, I did play Finland, but that's not technically, yeah, I don't know, just rambling now. Lots of places, everywhere. All right. Oh, Michelle, you lost my set list. No rest. Oh yeah, I told you I was gonna do some, I didn't tell you, I'm gonna do some old ones today. These are songs that I haven't really played in a minute, and I've been really enjoying getting to go back through them and refinding the songs again and adjusting them to how I perform now and how I feel now. And it's a really fun thing to write something, you know, 8 years ago and then not play it for a while and come back and be like, oh, I remember that little guy. That's my little kid, Johnny. Johnny's all grown up. Oh, he's different now. Don't judge me. Or do judge me. I don't really care, to be quite honest. What am I playing? Oh, yeah, funny little feeling. No rest. Yeah. Michelle, you been smoking the devil's lettuce or something over here? Going crazy. This next one is one of the first songs I actually ever wrote. I think it was alongside Flo and Midnight Dove. I don't remember which one came first, but this was one of the first ones I ever wrote and put online long, long time ago. And then it made its way eventually to the album Shadows. Yeah, let's do it.
Once it's gone, you feel so free, yeah, you're just like a bird flying through the trees. No path to God, where the hell you put your feet?
Yes. Yeah, that one I wrote many, many moons ago. Kind of written about loneliness and depression and sadness and all that fun stuff, you know? And avoiding it and overcoming it and getting better through dealing with it. That's what it's about. And letting it go and then finding freedom without having to have that on your back. All right, so we're going to do two more songs and then call it a day. Thank you guys again for tuning in. I appreciate all the support I've been experiencing. You know, as always, if you want to support me and help my team and crew out, you can go to the merch store, www.seanjamesmusic.com, and pick something up there. It really helps us out. And thank you for all your tips and donations that are going to charity as well as we try to defeat this beast. Yeah. Thanks for tuning in, y'all. I need to come up with jokes. I need to start a few jokes. So you guys, how about this? You guys, give me some really good jokes in the comments or post them and send them in messages to me and I'll steal them, make them my own, and then win. You know, everybody wins. You get your joke told. I'll take credit for it. No, maybe. I don't know. It just depends on how much I remember, I guess. But yeah, send me some jokes. I'm not very good at them. I need to learn some. Okay. Let's see. What are we going to do next? Maybe some piano. Piano. A lot of people have been asking me what this song's about. And I think you can pick up on little things here and there. I don't really want to go into full detail because this is a very personal experience and a relationship that I cherish. But Brother was written only like a year and a half. Well, no, now it's a year and a half, 2 years, something like that ago. And I was reflecting on this relationship that I had with this person who was going through a lot of difficult times, dealing with past and a lot of different things, suicidal tendencies, depression, substance abuse, everything like that. And it was a difficult time. And I don't really know what to say about this one just because I said it's a very personal experience. But, you know, we both found a way through and, you know, we're both better and doing well and life is good. And I hope that maybe this song can get out there and make people realize that you're not alone and people are going through hard times as well and have been through a lot of things. And again, you're not alone and there's always people there for you in one way or another if you just reach out and put it out there. Yeah, so this one's called Brother.
Thank you.
didn't like you when I first met you, but letting you grow on me. I've got a tendency to like the wilder ones. Haunted by demons, you are going through hell. I wanted you to be free. I didn't know if I could help or not, but I wouldn't flee. Now when I reach out in the dark, I don't feel you. Have we crossed the point of no return? I wanna be loud and clear and loud. Understand that to truly love you, I had to let you go, my brother. Talked for hours and the tears came down. You needed an escape. I'm glad you didn't end your life that day in spite of all that weight. Now when I reach out in the dark, I don't feel you. Have we crossed the point of no return? I wanna be loud and clear in that I miss you. But now I guess I understand that to truly love you, I had to let you go, my brother.
So we're going to do one more song. this next one is kind of a heavy one for me. It took me about 10 years to finish this. Kind of was dealing with a lot of emotions and past traumas that I never really dealt with for a long time. And I was kind of holding on my back. And, you know, I tried so many times to finish this song and it just didn't feel right. And eventually it finished on its own by me, you know, constantly revisiting it. And finally, when I had finished it, I knew I had finished it because I felt this weight lift off of me because I had said what I needed to say. And by doing that, by saying what I needed to say and ejecting this emotion into the song, I was able to release and let go of all that pain and trauma from the past. And, you know, I think that's something that I see as a huge goal of mine, is trying to help other people find that so that they can let go and move on and find happiness without having to deal with this chain around your ankle, which is, you know, past traumas, past emotions, hard times, you know, everything else. Yeah. So this one is called Love Will Find a Way.
The blood that filled his veins. to call if you're on the edge of a cliff. You can't find your grip. Don't lose hope. Love will find a way.
Thank you guys for tuning in. My name is Sean James, and I will see you next time. Thanks so much.